Student friends, almost all we are at the end of the topic number 5 of paper number 6. In the last week, we studied the internet accessing, and we studied that internet can be accessed by using the direct accessing or dedicated accessing, and second one is by dial-up accessing. We studied their respective advantages and disadvantages. Dedicated services has to possess a leased telephone line, and as if we are going to act as a service providers. You can give the facility of internet to the other clients also. But in case of dial-up accessing, this facility is not available. Dial-up facility is not regularly going to provide this service, because same telephone line is used for dialing the telephone, that is voice communication, as well as for the data communication. It may going to create the disturbance, and such all other aspects we studied. Whatever the hardware which are required, what is the software that is required for dedicated as well as for the dial-up internet connection with which we can access the internet. Today we are going to study almost all the last article, and that is internet account. To access the internet, maybe it is a dedicated one, or maybe it is a dial-up type of accessing, or one can utilize the facility of the internet to browse the internet services from the service provider. One should have an account on the internet. Till and until you don't have internet account, you can't access the internet. Maybe it is a dial-up, or maybe it is the dedicated one. So that's why internet account must and should be there. Till and until that account is there, one should not access the internet. And that's why internet account plays a very vital role. Obviously, for generating the internet account, you should spend some money for the ISP. You can get these services nowadays from Idea, from Airtel, from BSNL. So many companies are there which are going to provide this particular facility. But in all cases, you should have your own account on the service provider. So that is the reason why you are going to study, in short, what do you mean by internet account. Dear students, to access the internet, one should have an account with internet service provider, that is ISP. We are well aware that BSNL is the one of the service provider. Nowadays many service providers are available. You can get access of internet from Airtel, from Idea, from Zio card. So many companies are there, but you should have there your own account on that. The account may be a sale account, or it is TCP/IP account. Now let us understand the meaning of sale account and also the TCP/IP account. In sale account, computer act as a terminal directly connected to the internet host. Our computer is connected directly to the internet host. Host means who provides the service. There are two aspects. One is a host, another one is a guest. I think you are understanding the meaning. If someone comes to our home, he is going to act as a guest and we are going to act as a host. What is the role of guest? Guest has to keep quiet till and until the host provides something. The guest doesn't ask tea for host directly. But when host says, yes, do you want tea? Then he will say either yes or no. So that is the difference between a host computer and that of the guest or client computer. So from that point of view, we can say to open the sale account, if you have a sale account, our computer acts as a terminal, which is directly connected to the internet host. The host is one which is connected to the internet. Means host computer is connected to the internet and our computer is connected to the host. There is a direct account, TCP IC account, IP account is associated with the host computer. And you are going to connect with that particular host, you will have your cell account. That is the thing. One can view only text-based information. One can't view graphics. One can't hear sound. Thus, it provides the limited access. If you have got a cell account, limited access. Meaning thereby, you are a guest. Whatever host it is giving, you have to accept it. If host gives the water, okay, it's all right. You have to drink it if you want. Otherwise, you can keep it. If host offers something, you will get it. Till and until host offers, you won't get that particular thing, even though if you are interested to get it. So such account you can call it as it is a sale account. With this account, one can use the FTP, that is file transfer protocol. We studied it. IRC, Internet Relay Chatting, and email, and also www, that is World Wide Web. For browsing, accession is not possible. So, FTP, IRC, email, browsing are not possible if you have your cell account. Its cost is less, but it is not user friendly as it provides only the text information. Such account, you can call it as it is a cell account. But in TCP IP account, computer works as an internet host. Our computer itself is going to act as a host. You can provide service to the others. It is user friendly. It provides the graphical interface to the user. One can view graphics and one can hear the sound, but it is costly. You have to pay more money because you are going to a host. So to understand the cell account and TCP IP account, you should remember the relation between guest and host. For host, TCP IP account. For guest, it is cell account. Even though once you have opened the cell account or TCP IP account, you will get a domain to you and it address for you. And that is called as domain and addressing. If you open cell account or domain account, cell account or TCP IP account, every computer which has opened the account on the internet, it has a unique address. it provides a unique address to that particular computer. And that unique address is called as domain addressing. No two computers can have same address which are connected to the internet. There are two types of the address. One is a domain name and second one is IP address. These addresses and domain name helps computer to locate on the net. Your computer is located on the net by using the domain name and also the IP address. Now, let me understand the domain name. This system refers to systematic organization of the domain name. Domain name means where your computer lies. In which country, in which state, in which district, in which geographical region your computer is going to lie, and for which internet it is going to be connected. So that is going to be expressed by the systematic organization of the name, and that is known as the domain name. Domain name indicates the country in which computer is located and which organization owns it. Domain name is provided on the basis of geographical region or on the basis of the organization. For example, in India, it is represented by IN. For Australia, it is represented by AU. For United States, it is represented by US. For education organization, it is represented by UU. Up to this, country-wise domain name, I explained. Now, organization. If educational organization, it is represented by U. For commercial, it is represented by .com. These are the examples of the domain name. For example, JPL, VSNL, BSNL, anything out of three. VSNL, Videsh Seva Sanchar Nigam Limited. BSNL, Bharat Seva Sanchar Nigam Limited. JPL, Joint Program Level Limited. So all these are service providers. .net, BSNL.net, VSNL.net, JPL.net, like that. It can also be used. These can also be applicable. When software sees the domain name, it recognizes that computer is located in a particular area. For example, say if the domain name possesses the IN, it recognizes that computer is located in India on the network. And if it looks VSNL or BSNL, it recognizes that it is a service provider at a location JPL, JPI, that is Jaipur. So that is how it domain name is identified. Username is followed by @symbol, then in AU, US, UK are geographical domain names indicating the country. So this is how the domain name is going to be accessed. For example, all these are going to be summarized here. This is one of the example how you can write the domain name. rhk@mah.bsnl.net.in. This represents the domain name. It refers to the name RHK. It is the name of the user who is using this computer on the internet. That is represented by RHK. It is a username. Then there is a at hat represents the location where it is in MAH, means it is in Maharashtra. Then .BSNL. BSNL represents the ISP, that is a service provider. .NET represents it is on network. .IN means it is available in India. So this is how computer is going to be identified by its domain name. Some of the domain names are represented here. .com. .com means commercial organization. .net, it is a network service provider again. .edu, academic organization, that is an educational organization. .gov, government organization. .int, international organization. .mil, military organization. .org, non-commercial organization. Next, .in, related with India. .au, related with Australia. .us, related with United States. .uk, related by United Kingdom. .pk, represents Pakistan. .ch, represents the China. So this is how representing the domain name of computer. These are related with the geographical aspect. These are related to the organization aspect also. So this is how, if you have either SEL account or TCP IP account and you have provided with a domain name, then your computer will become a part of that particular internet. And if you have internet access browsing facility, then you can almost all get the facility of all the applications which you have studied, which are being provided under the title to be known as internet, which is the network of the network, or it is known as international network. Dear students, this is all about the aspect of the internet which we are expected to be covered in this particular topic. Next time, we'll go for the next aspect.